For obvious reasons, some of you know why I might be all about vision at this point in my life, but vision is something that's always been important to me in life and in faith. I Can See Clearly Now, sung by Jimmy Cliff, and that excerpt is a song that was on its second iteration when he sang it. It comes from the early 70s and was used again in the 90s and gets played on old-timey radio right now. It's a song that's about seeing beyond the clouds and the obstacles. On the screen are three images. Some of you will see one image. Some of you, in each of the characters, some of you will see one image. But there are two images in each character. And you may either choose to see the chalice or the two faces. You may choose to see the tree or the monkey and the lion. You may choose to see the woman's face or the man blowing the saxophone. They're all in each of those images. It's how you perceive it, how you look at it, and how you understand it. I say this because the gospel lesson that was just read was really all about perception. How people see what they see. Jesus has all these officials coming at him, demanding to know, okay, you're doing all these miracles. You've done this, you've done this, you've done this, you've done this. Are you going to tell us now that you're the Messiah? And you hear the answer. He talks about other sheep, sheep that know him, the ones that follow him, that he and the Father are one. It's a very oblique answer to say, you don't get it. If you are so caught up in the miracle, if you are so caught up in the mechanics of how it works, if you are so caught up in what is the scientific explanation for why this is happening, you don't get it. Because all he wanted you to do was look past the mechanics, past the physics, past the science, and see God. It's as simple as that. He's trying to say to people, look at me and see God. It's as simple as that. God works in all things. Look and see God. Today's Mother's Day. You know, ministers don't like preaching about Mother's Day. Do you know that? In my own family growing up, my father always pushed really hard the fact that it was in the church that's actually called Christian Family Sunday. You celebrate everybody. Ministers don't like celebrating Mother's Day for a very good reason. Not everybody likes it. We have an image of what a mother's supposed to be, and that's all we can see. We can't see past it. Can't see anything more than that. So let me tell you a story. I have struggled with this particular message about what to do with perception and how you deal with things and how you see things. How you see God working in this world. Because that's what we're really all about in faith, is how do we experience a relationship, personal and corporately, with our Creator. 20 years ago, almost 25 years ago, I came to Napanee as minister and worked there and was a part of what was called Belleville Presbytery. And I would interact with the churches in Belleville. Later on, I became a minister of the church in Belleville. There was a kind of strange little mission on the riverfront in Belleville called the Yahweh Harvest Mission. Now, I got to tell you that. I can still remember that name. I can't remember half the names of the churches in Belleville. Don't remember any of their ministers or any of the pastors. But I remember there was this guy that was running this mission down at the riverfront. And he was feeding homeless people, people without any income. And he disappeared. I don't know what happened to him. So as many of you know, I run an Airbnb. This week, a couple came to stay at my Airbnb. It turned out they were pastors going to a church conference for an evangelical church in Napanee. And we were talking. Turns out I knew this man from someplace, but he'd lost 180 pounds. It was the minister that I had lost sight of. And we got talking over the last 2 days. So I don't even call this a message. This is a ramble, because everything I wanted to say was reshaped by the conversation we had last night about mothers. I got to tell you that when he closed the mission, apparently 3 years ago, he started it in with a hot dog cart and hot dogs because that's all he could afford. He never took an income from this place. He lived basically off the donations that came in to, he lived as the people that he served. He ended up putting out $2 million worth of food to families over a 15-year period, feeding hundreds of thousands of people. And I would say you could thank his mother for that. He would have had trouble saying that because he was tortured by his mother. He would go to bed at night as a little boy, and she would come into his bedroom and burn his hands with her cigarettes. He spent years growing up trying to figure out why his mother would torture him and not his other siblings. Turned out he reminded her of his father, who had abandoned her and had treated her badly. Because he spent the early part of his adulthood trying to discover what made his mother tick, he began to see past his mother, to see what made her hurt, and to see what motivated her. And then he began to look at other people around himself in the world. And out of that grew a ministry that has had a profound impact on hundreds of thousands of people. He can thank his mother for his ministry. What do you see? Do you see a cruel person? Or do you see a person who hurt so much they took their pain out on others? And that's what Jesus was wanting us to see when we looked at him. See what's motivating him. See what drives him. See what creates his humanity to be the Christ. It's God working in a life. My friend Jim would say, God works in all things for all purposes to become good. This is Mother's Day and we celebrate love. That's what we really celebrate on Mother's Day, whether you want to call it Mother's Day, whether you want to call it Christian Family Sunday, whether you want to call it Sunday. It's a day in which we celebrate love. The bulletin says faith, family, and friends. It's about those relationships in life. You have to use all of those things to see God's action in this world. That's what Christ was for. We had to put a human face on it. When you want to put a human face on God's love, you understand God has compassion for everybody. And when you seek to have compassion for everybody, it will transform your life. It's a life lived beyond judgment. It's a life lived beyond fear. It's a life lived with hope. And at 3 o'clock this morning, I was being retaught that lesson by this friend sitting in my kitchen having coffee with me. A friend, a guy I had met 25 years ago and had lost sight of, and he showed up on my door on a night that I needed a sermon. You think God isn't working out there to make all things work? If you take anything from this message today, don't go, oh, rah, rah, it's Mother's Day. Go, we thank God for every human being, no matter how blessed or cursed we think they are when they come into our life. Because they make us see something more if we are willing to open it, our eyes to it. But here's the key. Here's the really big key. Like there's two images in each of those pictures up there. There's always two images you can see in every situation in life. The positive or the negative. You get to choose whether it's a positive image you're seeing or the negative image you're seeing. But that's a choice. That is totally your human choice. God gives us strength. to see the positive. Who knows? Maybe like my friend Jim, it'll feed 200,000 people. Maybe that's how the loaves and fishes worked. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.